Here we have a 3rd gen CPU Gigabyte motherboard. Basically, when it came to us, it is not turning on. Plug in the power, and when pressing the power button, nothing happens. Sometimes the fan will spin a little bit or so, and nothing else, it just won't turn on. So first thing obviously we did is swap the power supply out. Here is the replacement power supply, and even with this it didn't do anything. This usually means there is a short to ground somewhere, so I decided to remove some of the components, so graphic card is the easy option. Then I gave the computer a good clean all the dust out, and even without the GPU it didn't make any difference, it still will not turn on. So the next best thing to do is take the board out, see if there is any damaged pins on the outside or anywhere around the board. I cannot see any damaged pins or burnt components on the board, so I assume the motherboard physically looks okay. There is definitely internal damage, maybe to a MOSFET or a component, and being such a cheap model, I don't have too much time to spend on fixing this. So I decided to look around, see if I get a compatible board. And just before swapping out another motherboard, I decided to test the board again outside the casing of the computer. Maybe something touching the metal casing and shorting the board, and it was not to be. So here is the board. This one has the i3 processor. The faulty computer has an i5, which is still fine. So what I decided to do is, first thing first, try the i5 processor from the other computer into this board, which I don't know is working yet or not, and see if it will turn on. And after plugging it all in, guess what? It did not turn on. So this indicated to me that if my board is working, then the problem is CPU, which is quite rare. Thank you. So then I removed the i5 CPU from this replacement board and put in the i3 CPU and see what happens. And just to rule out the power button in the front, I'm just shorting the power button with a metal object, and the fan is spinning. So this tells me my donor or replacement board and the CPU, i3 CPU, are fine. Something's not right. So definitely the CPU i5 is either not compatible with this board or it's just faulty. So what we're going to do is get this board up and running and do a BIOS update, and then putting the i5 CPU back in here. By the way, I also did try the i3 CPU in the other board, and same result, it will not turn on. So that's great. We get to see Windows and it's crashed, obviously from previous shutdown. And we're going to go back into Windows, do all the drivers because it's a different motherboard, and then do the BIOS update. Now I am reprogramming the BIOS with the Gigabyte utility as BIOS application. So you can see here it is the i3 CPU. I realized I could use the Windows Zoom utility. Here I'm just taking a snapshot, I'm going to zoom in the picture. Very techy way of doing, okay? There we go, that's the i3 CPU. And I'd rather get the i5 CPU working, so one last resort. With the BIOS updated, with maybe new CPU information too, I'm going to put in the i5 CPU and see if it turns on. If not, then I'm just going to put back the i3 and put a new thermal paste and we shall be good to go. It is very rare for a CPU and motherboard to die at the same time. One day if I have time, I'll go through and find the fault, but today there is no time.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.